classics. Oh, there you are. As I was saying, the classics. They bring culture to an otherwise uncivilized time. Dickens, Tolstoy, Anonymous, and others. After all, where would we be without the willowy byplay of Swift, the timeless insights into the human condition of Dostoevsky? The loftily constricted prose of Jane Austen. The majesty of the Bronte sisters. The young one is rather cute. The pointless, ponderous pontifications of Proust. The gee, look what I learned in school today. One upsmanship of Shaw. The my fish is bigger than your fish meanderings of the macho Ernest Hemingway. Let's face it, I'm sick of it. Yes, yes. Unbeknownst to my wife, these classics are what this program is all about. These are the books, the classics, if you will, of the pulp genre. Stories of blackmail, midnight trysts, and homicidal hijinks. There's no whiny, introspective, tea-sipping ninnies here, no. These are books populated with caffeine-addicted hitmen, bongo-slamming hippie cannibals, and psychotic women from outer space. Each week on Pulp Classics, we will condense a full-length pulp novel into a 24-minute teleplay for your pleasure. Although they are heavily edited, I promise to leave all the good bits in. Tonight's story is written by Paul Siffredi, an unemployed tire stripper from Akron. It was written in 1947 after an ill-fated trip he made to St. Paul, Minnesota. It's entitled I'll Be Damned. Though Siffredi had no following during his lifetime, he has recently accrued a massive following amongst the literati of Newfoundland. I'll Be Damned is a story of greed, lust, and a twist of lemon. Let's see Dickens do that, eh? It's a story of Don Giovanni, a man twisted by his own obsession for naughty girls. Well, let's get on with it, eh? Tonight's pulp classic, I'll Be Damned.
Yes?
Hi! Are you Mr. Jamison?
Yes.
Hi. I'm Dan Giovanni from Love Coast Singing Telegram Service. I have a message from Marcia. Can I share it with you? Okay.
Okay.
Dear Studs, I've been walking all over you so long, my feet are chapped. If you call, I'll hang up. If you write, I'll return the letter. If I see you at my apartment, I'll shoot you. Yours truly, Marcia. Oh, that's not all. Just a second. Love hurts, love scars, love wounds, and mars any heart not tough or strong enough to take a life.
They gave me the tough jobs, the ones no one else would do. The breakups, the pink slips, the medical test results. I was good. I had a million ways of saying you lose. Rap, gospel, opera, even country. Some guys won't do country, but it was all the same to me. Real life, however, well, that was a tune of a different sort for me.
Boring. I'm just busy, all right? I got a lot of work to do.
I don't believe you anymore. You don't come over, you don't return my calls. I don't know what else to do. What should I do?
Maybe you're doing too much, huh? Maybe you're too damn nice or something. Maybe you treat me too good, huh? Let me eat.
What was wrong with me? Some guys wait their whole lives to meet a girl like Julie. Julie was nice, but she was too nice. If I liked nice, I never would have let Brenda go. Women, they like ice cream. There's 100 different flavors. And Brenda, she was pure vanilla. But this girl was cool almond mocha in a black dress.
Hope this helps you grow up. Sure you wouldn't like anything else?
Yeah. Could you put some hot water on this, please?
Sure. What's with the towel?
I'm a singer. It's a professional thing.
A singer, huh?
What the hell's going on over there? We got bacon up!
Hey, buddy. What are you doing staring at my wife?
Ain't doing nothing.
My husband of yours is awful jealous.
Don't mind him. He hasn't touched me since I turned 18.
When a pretty woman smiles at you and you see a ring, don't smile back. I just broke the cardinal rule of backstreet hash joint etiquette.
So you must be Mrs. Cherry.
Virginia. And that's my husband, Pops.
Don't call me that. The bacon's getting cold.
Damn entertainers coming in here causing trouble.
Church bell rang 29 times.
Line! Line! Mop down the front row!
I'll be right out there, boss man.
For each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald.
That song brings back such memories. It's my prom theme.
Always happy to take a request from a pretty lady.
I come into the joint for with some tea and lemon. What I got was a bucket of trouble. When I saw the guy with the mop. I knew something was up. I didn't know quite what, but then the word kind of etched a little notch in my skull. S-E-X.
Yeah, Dan, listen, this is Mo down at Loveco. If you can find a way to work the word spina bifida into a song, I got a job for you tomorrow. And by the way, the Wilson torn between two lovers job, yeah, you can cancel that. Hung himself this afternoon. Good thing we got the money up front. See you tomorrow.
Hi, Dan. It's 9 o'clock, and I'm waiting for your call. Call me. This is Julie. Bye.
Hey, tons of fun. This is Pops from down at the diner. That woman you've been drooling over the last several weeks down at the diner is my wife. And I know what you want. So unless you want to be the chopped liver on the menu, you'll stay away. So have a good day, you son of a bitch.
I love you. I've really never been so happy in all my life.
Yeah, I'm happy too, you know? Real happy.
Every day could be like this, I'd be in heaven. I just know it.
Yeah, I look forward to waking up with you every morning the rest of my life, hon. Really. Got a light?
You are my wife. You are my wife!
I wanted to do was take a long walk. As I found out later, it would be the longest walk of my life. Mrs. Cherry.
Hi.
Hi.
I was on my way to the diner. I forgot to screen the grill.
Huh? Oh, yeah.
What are you doing out this time of night?
I just thought I'd take a walk. I got a lot on my mind. You know, nothing really.
You're kind of a faraway look when you're in the diner tonight. Who is she?
Who was she's the question. Just an old girlfriend. I was feeling kind of guilty, that's all.
Yeah, well, love can be a cruel thing, but I wouldn't know anything about love.
Hey, listen, do you want me to walk you to the diner?
No, that's okay, but if you come by and you see me somehow, okay?
Bye.
I'd spent enough years in the rewarding vocation of food preparation to know that you don't scrape a grill in high heels. There was no way I could sleep now. I had to see. Why would she tell me she was going to the diner but not want me to walk with her? Common sense told me to go home, but the naughty boy in me, the one who's never satisfied, needed to know. The old man's office was converted into a twisted classroom of seduction. I couldn't tell who was the teacher and who was the student. I couldn't tell who was good and who was bad.
Maybe you can teach me all about the Dewey Decimal System, baby.
My eyes lingered on a parade of shadows. My ears feasted on a banquet of perversion. They were out of control, and so was I. May Almighty God and Julie forgive me.
Darn singer or a friggin' poet. Something I could never be, but a friggin' dishwasher.
Oh, man, that's something you could never be.
Hey, that's her opinion, man, not mine.
I'll show you scum who the mayor out here is.
Don't hurt him, Pop!
Don't call me Pop!
Let's get out of here. He's going crazy.
God!
Through life frustrated and bitter like me.
Make your peace with your God, whoever it may be. Would somebody call the friggin' cops?
I told you everything I know. I didn't do it.
I don't know anything. I didn't do it!
All right. Calm down. Now, you and I have a relationship. And relationships are based on understanding. Now, you understand that you're in trouble. And I understand that you're a liar. But that doesn't mean we can't work together. Now, I'm going to ask you some questions. You're gonna give me answers. There are no wrong answers, okay? Now, why did you go into the diner and pop Mr. Cherry? Wrong answer. Look, we got the knife, we got the fingerprints, we got you at the scene.
Well, how do you explain this?
I gave you that one.
You did what?
How do you explain this?
It's the oddest thing. He tripped over his own shoelaces. I'll take complete responsibility.
I'll see that you do. Now let's question the suspect properly, okay?
All right, the girl told us that you...
They're not girls, Ben. They're women.
The wife told us that you were hitting on her all night. Okay, you got upset. You sat and stewed for a while. Then you couldn't take it anymore. So, like a true moron, you broke into the place, stabbed the guy, and it tripped over your own shoelaces.
Ben, that's all just conjecture. Why don't we hear Dan's side of the story, okay?
We know Dan's side of the story, and it's written on this. But I'll tell you the way you like to hear it. He allegedly broke into the place. He allegedly stabbed the guy. Then he allegedly tripped over his own shoelaces. Ain't that right, dirtbag?
That's no way to address a suspect, Ben.
All right. Alleged dirtbag.
Ben, you've been through a painful divorce. Why don't you sit down for a moment? Hand me the reins on this one and I'll ride it for a while. Why don't you sit there and take a deep breath and get rid of some of that misplaced hostility and tension, okay? I know you've been through a lot, and you're in a new strange environment. If I were you, I'd be upset too. I can't speak for my somewhat excitable colleague, although he means well. But I can say that the department is your friend. We're here to serve and protect, even you.
Sir?
Yes, Dan?
Aren't I entitled to a lawyer?
Ben, don't tell me you didn't read this man his rights.
Bring home the milk. Tape wrestling. Cuff the suspect. I knew I forgot something.
Hey, Sammy. Take it easy on the heavyset laden there. Ben roughed him up pretty bad. Got him some fresh clothes from Lost and Found, we did.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Sam Shaw, your court-appointed lawyer.
Yes, sir.
You only got a couple minutes between court cases. Hey, how are they treating you?
Listen,
I haven't got a lot of time. What I needed to tell you more important than anything else is don't talk to the police. You got it?
Sir,
I've been taking a look at your case, really. I don't have a lot of time. What I want you to know more than anything else is that I'm your attorney. I'm here to work for you. This is still the United States of America, no matter how many holes they blow in the Constitution, all right? We're still here. You're still presumed innocent. The prosecution has to prove this case beyond any reasonable doubt, okay?
Okay.
You're entitled to a lawyer and an experienced one. I've done thousands of cases, hundreds of murder cases. I think you're in good hands. I could be making a lot more money in some big law firm, but I'd rather be your lawyer. I'm here because I care.
That makes you feel good, sir.
Another thing is, I've been reading your case, and seriously, they're going to have some problems here. I think they're going to have some real problems proving your case. You got some strong legal issues, Mr. Rodriguez.
I don't think there's going to be any... Sir. My name's not Rodriguez.
It's not. Okay. I'm just... Becerra?
No.
Krenwinkel?
No.
Von Bulow?
No, sir.
What is it?
Dan Giovanni.
Dan Giovanni. Okay. I got it. I'm sorry. Been real busy lately, so I've been, you know, just running around a lot. Okay, this is the... You're the bastard that killed Pops!
What?
When I was a kid, we used to go there every Saturday and have free breakfast when he gave it out to the Boy Scouts and their families. The man fried the best pork tenderloin in town. Great, and you gotta take his life. Unbelievable. They say everybody deserves a defense, but sometimes you gotta wonder.
Sir, I didn't kill anybody.
What I advise you to do is, whatever they offer,
yeah,
out of the goodness of their hearts, snap it up. Just take whatever they do. I don't know what they'll offer you, but if they offer you anything, just take it, okay? And by the way, here, I think you might be needing this.
What the hell's going on?
Court, I'll be talking to you again.
I'm innocent.
Daniel Salvatore Giovanni. You've been tried by a jury of your peers, and the verdict is...
Guilty of love in the first degree.
Guilty? Well, he's not innocent.
I suppose he's guilty, technically. But isn't society really to blame?
He's guilty as hell!
I'm not even in this novel, but I say guilty! Kabong.
No sense going against the grain now. Guilty.
They got me on murder one. If I'm a good boy and keep my nose clean, I'll be 50 when I see the light of day again. And due to prison overcrowding, well, the accommodations they came up with were less than fit for a human being. It's been a year since fate knocked on my door and sang its sad song. But what I didn't realize is it ain't all over until the fat guy sings.
You want to talk to me, huh?
Ain't did something but all them prisons overcrowding like that. Put you up in that finest facility, though, huh?
How was your holiday season? Hope it was joyous enough for you, partner.
I'm gonna get you one of these days, pal.
You got a visitor waiting for you, big guy. I'll go round her up.
Brenda?
That's right, Dan. Your girl's come home.
But you look different.
It's the new me. You wanted excitement. You were bored with me. It's more fun this way.
What way?
You know, being bad. You always like the bad girls. Like that waitress? I know you liked her.
My God, what have I done? What have I done?
I didn't go there to hurt him. I wanted her, but it all worked out. You're here and we can be together.
What? Together?
It's better this way, Dan. You'll see. You'll be safe here. Dan, say something. Don't shut me out again. Say something. Sing it. Sing it for me.